Hey, Coach Irma here. So what's the number one mistake people tend to make? Well, people just stop and they quit. That's it. That's a simple thing. They stop and quit. Let me give you a simple example. They say in life that life is just like a big old mountain, Mount Everest. And 50% of people start and go up, 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 up. They stop at 50%. And then this something happens, they cap out. And instead of continuing, they actually go back and they go deeper than they started and gain 10, 20, 30 pounds or more. Now there's an average, I think is like about 10% of people actually start and they continue going further up. And there's a saying that you'd rather be going up the mountain and going over the mountain than keep on going the same mountain and sliding back down. And that's a very high, 50 to 90% of most people. And the reason why for me it comes easy for me is my father was a gymnast and he was a perfectionist. And so he always taught us that we had to practice. And he was kind of like my military Navy SEAL. He was mean. Ah, women are weak. You can't do it. I bet you're gonna fail. Watch this. And so when someone talked that way to me, I wanted to show him, watch, I'm gonna show you. I'm gonna show you my way. And my father would never let me beat him. He would take us, he was a Sunday father. We would actually go and we would compete and do actually a isometric hold, legs in the air, like when the pommel horse. And we would hold for who was the strongest one. The one that dropped down was the weakling. And from 9, 10, 11, all the way up to like 16, 17 years old, my fat old man would always beat me. He never let me beat him. Until the age of 16, I trained and trained and trained. And I was in pretty much the same shape I am right now. And I beat my old man in a sprint and a isometric hold. And I realized that the isometric hold, holding yourself in that position for long periods of time, competing with your neighbor, is one of the best ways to work out. And I love my father for it. I'm glad he was mean to me. I'm glad he said that because he, every time I actually get a little more, I remind myself that when you plateau, that you have to keep going. And then I'm competing with myself. Before I would compete with other people, no one's gonna help you. But if you compete with yourself, the world will open the doors and help you. So, are you the person that keeps going up and down and sliding down? Or do you wanna finally get up and keep on going? If you need help getting over Mount Everest, my job is to give you the map and tools so that you can keep on going. If you fall 10 times, we help you get up so that you can keep going. It's not the mountain, it's the step in front of the mountain. Don't look at the mountain, look at the step. And if you need help, click like, and I'll help you get to your dreams one step at a time. Coach Irma saying, keep on living and lifting. Peace.